Hey guys, it's Heidi. Welcome back. In today's video, I wanted to test out the Wow Dream Coat and find out if it will actually wow me. This is an Allure Award winner. It's supposed to be some kind of anti-frizz miracle product. So I've been specifically saving it for today to test it out for the very first time right here, right in front of you guys, so that we can all see for ourselves if these stuff works or not. The Wow Dream Coat is basically a heat activated polymer that promises to create a coat to protect your hair from extreme humidity, just help you have a very frizz-free type of sleek, straight hair look. Here in Buenos Aires, it's just a famous city for its humidity. Just basically makes your hair a little bit unmanageable and your blowouts don't last. Even straightening your hair doesn't last that long because there's very little we can do against, you know, those very extra humid days, right? I have to admit, I am a little bit skeptical. You know, there's so many hyped up products out there that I wouldn't be surprised if this was one. And I did pay quite a bit of money for this product, so yeah, I would hate to be disappointed. And what actually caught my eye the most about this product is that it's supposed to last up to 3 shampoos. So what I'm gonna do today is walk you through the application, and then I'm going to do some checkings throughout the rest of my day and possibly in the next couple of days to see if this has a long-lasting effect like it claims. And yeah, it says here to shampoo and condition and towel dry. All of those things are already done. Divide the hair in sections, spray each section liberally, then comb through to make sure that it's all evenly applied. Blow dry each section with a brush, and it stresses here that it's a drier heat activated type of product. So those are exactly the steps I am going to be taking to put this one to the test. So I feel like I evenly saturated my hair, but just like the instructions say, I am going to comb through to make sure that it's actually 100% evenly distributed. And while I'm doing this, I am imagining a world free of frizz. Wouldn't that be wonderful? So now I'm going to section my hair one more time. This time it is so that I can blow dry my hair more comfortably, section by section, piece by piece, and hopefully that will help us with a better result. All right, so for blow drying, I'm going to be using my Olivia Garden Nanothermic Brush and my gazillion year old professional hair dryer. Just in case you guys are wondering, it's a 1200 watt type of hair dryer. I really want this product to work, you guys. I can't tell you how much. Let's see how this goes. So far, I can tell you that my hair feels a lot more manageable, a lot softer to the touch. And another great thing is that it does not smell. It doesn't smell at all. I was really scared that it would have some kind of formal in it, which is absolutely banned in my country, but it just doesn't smell like that at all, and it does not irritate my eyes like products containing formal do. To share some preliminary thoughts. There's one thing this product will not do for you, and there's two things that I think it will do. This product has not saved me any time whatsoever. As far as the time that usually takes me to blow dry all these amount of hair, quite a bit of a workout, I may add. I'm feeling a little bit hot and sweaty. It will leave it softer, more manageable. So far, frizz free without any type of heat protector or hair oils or anything like that. So thumbs up for that. And the other thing that I feel that it has given me is incredible shine. I mean, look at that. Keep in mind that my hair is bleached, a shine suction thing. I'm super pleased in that sense. Typically, I would need a flat iron in order to get this type of result, and I did not have to do that today. So that gets me super, super excited, and definitely the only one thing that I'm intrigued is whether this is going to be a long-lasting effect or if as soon as I get outside in the street, this is going to go all like poof because I did not use a hair straightener. So we're about to find out that. Stay tuned because I'm going to be checking in with you guys in a bit. I was just filming another video in case you see the same outfit, but I wanted to do a day two update of my color wow dream coat experience. This morning I jumped into the shower with a bun, and of course I didn't want to wash my hair, but I do take quite hot like steam showers. So I guess my point is that there was humidity involved. There were like little tiny droplets for sure because I did not wear a shower cap. So I kind of did it on purpose, and also because that's how I usually do things. Like I don't wear a shower cap. I should, but I don't. So anyways, it was exposed to a lot of humidity, which is the whole point of the dream coat, is to protect you from that frizz caused by humidity. And I do feel like it has a very nice, quite long-lasting effect. So according to the weather app, there is a 59% humidity right now in Buenos Aires, 60% chance of rain. The forecast also says that tomorrow is going to rain. Like almost for sure, almost 100% sure that it's going to rain tomorrow. So I feel like I've already done a very good test of this product, and the silkiness, the softness, the luminosity that it gives my hair. I mean, it's not flawless, but it is still there. I'm going to update you guys after I have shampooed my hair and on a day when it's actually going to rain, and that's where my hair really gets out of control. I'm gonna insert a clip right now of how my hair usually looks like on a rainy day when I blow it out without any type of taming products or flat irons. So that's all for now. I'm going to update you guys again. This is how my hair looked like after one shampoo, and of course I blow dried it also, but I do feel like it hanged in there in spite of all that rain because of the color wow and that kind of polymer that protects your hair from humidity. So I feel like I've done a very long testing, and I put this product to some very, very hard conditions, and I'm happy to say that I found a great anti-frizz product that I feel like you guys will enjoy as well. So that's it for today, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for new videos that will be coming up really soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you all again on my next one. Ciao.